Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will start with the same lesson, how the state government works. In the last lecture, I have explained you about the responsibility, whose responsibility is to work for the welfare of the people. And in this lesson, we are going to study about only the state government, how the state government works for the people. So, in the last lecture, we have studied about the conversation between the two girls. They are reading the news given in the newspaper about the water shortage, health problems, and so many things. And also, one conversation between them was about the rally. Some of the people were demanding to a person, and the person who was answering to the people was called MLA. So in this lecture, we are going to study about who is MLA. So let us start with the topic today. So who is MLA? First of all, children, I want to give you one small homework. Today's your homework is you will find out the name of the MLA of your area. Now, who is MLA? MLA is the member of the Legislative Assembly. Now, what is Legislative Assembly? Legislative Assembly is the place where the people, that is the ministers, for example, these MLAs and all, they gather together and they work for the state. Legislative assemblies are in the capital city. So, the MLA is the member of the Legislative Assembly. He or she is elected representative of the people. Elected representative means through the election process. Through the election process, he is elected by the people, and when he gets elected and he becomes the member of the Legislative Assembly. The person who is elected by the people becomes the member of the Legislative Assembly and thus forms the government at the state level. So children, first of all, only who is MLA? So one thing you have to keep in mind is that MLA is a person, he is elected representative of the people and he is the member of the Legislative Assembly. So let us take the example, let us study through the example how the MLA is elected. Now let us move towards the another part, that how the election process takes place. Now children, see, our country India is divided into states, okay, and each state is divided into different various constituencies. Now what is constituencies? A state is, suppose this is one state, and a state is divided into different constituencies. The size of the it is not necessary that each constituency is of the same size. It depends on the number of the people, that is the population. So it depends. So a state is divided into various constituencies. And for example, Himachal Pradesh. Let us take the example of the Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh is divided into 68 constituencies. So a country is divided into states, and again a state is divided into different constituencies, that is different groups. So now only I gave you the example, that find out the name of the MLA of your constituency. Okay, so that also you will do. So a state is divided into different constituencies, and from each constituency one representative is elected. Means election is taken in all the constituencies. Means all the constituencies, in this constituency also we have the election, in this constituency also we have the election. So election is conducted in all the constituencies in which the state is divided. and a member from each constituency, one member is elected and he is the MLA from that constituency. The elected representative of that constituency is the MLA of the constituency. So now this Himachal Pradesh is divided into 68 constituencies. So now in Himachal Pradesh we have 68 MLAs from constituency. Okay children, so we have 68 members elected from one state. Now these 68 members are the members of the Legislative Assembly. These, they become the member of the Legislative Assembly and they are the MLA. So each constituency has one MLA and all these MLAs, they work together in the Legislative Assembly. So now these 68 MLAs, they will come together, they will have the discussion, and from among these 68 MLAs, one will be the Chief Minister. They will discuss among themselves and one member will be, one MLA among them will become the Chief Minister of the state. How it is decided that who will become the Chief Minister? Now see here children, now different MLA belongs to the different political parties and the political party whose MLA have won more than half the number of the constituencies in the state can be said to be in a majority. Now children, here the example, let us take the example of the Himachal Pradesh. Now this is the result of the assembly election of Himachal Pradesh which was held in 2017. Now in this election, now as we say that now as the MLAs belong to the different political parties, the MLA from the Bharatiya Janata Party, that is BJP, were 44, Indian National Congress were 21, Communist Party of India was one MLA was elected from this party, and independent, that is those who don't belong to any party, one member was elected. So one MLA was elected. So total 68 MLAs were elected from the Himachal Pradesh constituencies. So now how, what we say, what do we mean by the majority? Now children see here, the party which has the maximum number of the MLAs is said to be the party in majority, that is the ruling party. So now here in case of Himachal Pradesh, as BJP has 44 MLAs, BJP has formed the government and become the ruling party. Now children, see here, now one MLA, now this, as BJP is the ruling party, now one MLA out of these 44 MLAs, one MLA, these 44 MLAs have the discussion among themselves, and out of these 44, one MLA out of them becomes the Chief Minister. So now out of 44, one becomes the Chief Minister. One becomes the Chief Minister. So now 43 MLAs are left. Now this Chief Minister, the MLA who becomes the Chief Minister, selects the other ministers from these 43 MLAs. So for example, out of these 43 MLAs, health minister, education minister, there are so many other ministers who are working under the Chief Minister, and these other ministers are selected by the Chief Minister, and the Chief Minister and these other ministers who are selected by the chief minister are appointed by the governor. Means the governor of the state appoints them as the chief minister and the other ministers. Means we have seen this, the Shapath Vidhi and all, which takes place after the election. So governor appoints that MLA that from today onwards you are going to work as the chief minister of the state, and the other ministers are also and other ministers are also appointed by the governor. So this is the procedure how the chief minister is elected. So now children, now we come to the, let us come to the point. Now Bharatiya Janata Party, because this party has the maximum number of the MLAs, it has become the ruling party. Now what about these other MLAs from INC, Communist Party and Independent? So what about these other 24 MLAs? These 24 MLAs are the members of the opposition party. So this is about the ruling party and the opposition party. So children, I hope you have understood how the chief minister is elected. But children, at times the ruling party, this ruling party, now here BJP, it is not necessary that in the ruling party BJP will be only the one party. The other parties may also join with the ruling party, and that is called the coalition. And we means when the other political party join hand with the ruling party, it works with the ruling party, and that is called the coalition among the political parties. So this is about the election process. So children, I hope you have understood who is MLA. Let us recall once again, MLA is a person who is elected by the people from their constituency. A country is divided into state, a state is divided into different constituencies, and from each constituency one member is elected who is called the MLA of that constituency. Now the MLAs from all the constituencies come together in the legislative assembly, and in the legislative assembly they discuss among themselves. These 68 MLAs, they come together in the legislative assembly, and the MLAs, and these MLAs are from the different political parties, and the political party which has the majority of the MLAs become the ruling party, and the other MLAs become the member of the opposition party. And one among the ruling party, one MLA becomes the chief minister, and the other remaining MLAs are appointed by the chief minister as the other ministers. And this way this is the procedure how our state government works. So children, for today we have completed the topic who is MLA and how the chief minister and the other ministers are elected in a state government. So today we will stop here. In the next lecture we will move towards the another topic, that is debate in the legislative assembly. When these all MLAs, when they come together in the legislative assembly, how the debate take place. In the next lecture I will continue with the same topic. Thank you.